Our native garden here at the Garden Gallery Demonstration Garden, part of Johnson County K-State Research and Extension, continues to grow. My name's Dennis Patton. I'm the horticulture agent here. And so today's topic is going to be on weed control. When you plant a new native garden, if you go back to soil prep, we bared the soil. And that means you turned up a lot of soil. Whenever you turn soil up, weeds are going to be the result. And so one of the biggest problems with establishing a native planting are how you're going to control weeds. Because weeds will take over your planting. Because natives are a little slow to establish. It takes them about 3 years to fully establish. So how are you going to control the weeds? Well, you have a couple of options. First of all, is you can hand control them. That means you get on your hands and knees, you dig out the weeds, and that's going to be a continual process. You can also use some chemical herbicides. Now, I will tell you, most people that gravitate towards natives because the pollinators and the insects don't like to use chemical herbicides. And so we're not going to really focus on those. And the other way you can do that is to put down some sort of barrier. And there's a couple ways people will do that. Some people will use a cardboard, newspaper, and they'll shade out the soil. Or others will use a wood chip mulch. But I've got to warn you, stay on top of the weeds. They're easier to control when they're small. So when you're preparing to put in a native planting, always have how you're going to control weeds, because that's going to be a problem in getting them established. So let's stay on top of the weeds. This has been Dennis Patton with Johnson County K-State Research Extension for your tip on putting in a native garden.